Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. In this week's discussion on the celestial sphere, we are going to talk about galactic coordinates and what those mean in terms of determining positions of objects in the sky. So, what are galactic coordinates? Well, the galactic coordinates that we look at are measured relative to the plane of the Milky Way galaxy. Now, if you recall, we've used other different things as our standard, whether it be the celestial equator, which is the Earth's equator projected out. We've used things like the ecliptic, which is the apparent path of the sun. Here we're using the galaxy itself. So that means we can measure a galactic latitude given by the lowercase letter b, and a galactic longitude given by the lowercase letter L. So that would tell you how far you are above or below the galactic plane. That would be told by the latitude, and the galactic longitude would then be tell you how far you are around the sky. Now, like any other, we need reference points here, and the reference points would be the galactic center. How do we determine that point of longitude? As you recall, longitude always needs a specific reference point to be measured from. Well, for that, we choose the position from our sun looking toward the center of the galaxy. So that gives us the reference point, and that's given a galactic longitude of zero. And then we measure along that to really be able to see and to determine the coordinates. Now, when we look at this, we can look at this in a more schematic sense here. And here we see the celestial equator in yellow there. And then we can see the galactic equator kind of tilted relative to that. So if we wanted to determine the position of an object there relative to the galactic coordinates, we would then use, as shown in the image here, we would use, there is the galactic center, so we measure relative to that, and we would measure the direction along here till we get to the location, and then we'd measure the direction north or south, and that would give us the latitude. So the longitude would be measured along the galactic plane itself. The latitude would be measured above or below that. And those would give us our coordinates. So we can use all of those then to determine the coordinates of the object in the sky. Now, the galactic poles, you can see we have the galactic poles there. We talked about the plane of the galaxy, but there will be galactic poles just like there is a north celestial pole. And the galactic pole seen over to the side, there will be a north and a south galactic pole. North galactic pole up here, and the south galactic pole down here. Now note that they are nowhere near the celestial poles. And that's because the plane of the galaxy is not the same as the plane of Earth's orbit. So Earth is tilted relative to the galaxy is essentially what that is telling us. Now, what can we learn from galactic coordinates? Well, they tell us a few things. And what we can look at would be that we're identifying positions relative to our galaxy. So if we're looking at distant objects in the galaxy, we'll have small galactic latitudes because they're in our galaxy and our galaxy is flattened. Now that does not apply to nearby objects. Nearby objects could be at very far high or low galactic latitudes simply because we're kind of in the middle of them and we're not seeing them off in the distance. But as we look to very distant galactic objects, they would have a relatively small galactic latitude being seen close to the plane of the Milky Way. So let's go ahead and finish up with our summary here. And what we've looked at today is about galactic coordinates. And we really saw that they are measured relative to the Milky Way, not the celestial equator, as we used in a previous set. We can use the galactic latitude and longitude to determine the position of an object in the sky, just like we did with things like right ascension and declination, or altitude and azimuth, and the other different coordinates that we've used. And it identifies generally the positions of objects within the galaxy or relative to the plane of the galaxy itself. So that concludes this discussion on galactic coordinates. We'll be back again next week for another topic on the celestial sphere. So until then, Have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.